by me. So I bet you're wondering why I cry. Woe is me. I'm humbled. I'm perplexed. And my job is on the line. If I can't get my act together, oh, it's just a matter of time. Oh, woe is me. Well, as I was saying, King Darius trusts me. I was his number one cub, his right-hand lion. I always got my man. But my jaws, I couldn't open. I just couldn't open. Oh, dear. I'm afraid I'm ahead of myself. So let's just go back to where it all began. Darius the Mede is king, and these people are still captive. But some of them are merchants, and silversmiths, and bakers. In fact, they're doing all right, if you know what I mean.
Oh, yeah.
One of them, Daniel, is even a leader in the court of King Darius. Now, see, the problem began when Darius, he divided his kingdom into 120 cities, and he put a governor over each one of them. And then he had three presidents in charge of the governors. And one of those presidents was...
Daniel!
You guessed it! And before long, Daniel proved himself to be wiser than all of the other presidents. And King Darius noticed Daniel's abilities, and that there was something different about Daniel. And he put him in charge of the whole kingdom. Extraordinary spirit in this extraordinary man. Once the captive from Jerusalem, now a leader in our land. He has wisdom, he has courage, and obeys the king's command. Just a different kind of spirit in a different kind of man. He can look into the future and predict what's going to be. All the sages in our land agree he has ability. But the secret of his power is in his God above. And he prays to him three times a day to show to him his love. There's an extraordinary spirit in this extraordinary man, and the king has thought of placing him above others in command. For his knowledge is divine, and the king understands. There's an extraordinary spirit in this extraordinary man. There's an extraordinary spirit in this extraordinary man. Well, after Daniel's appointment, the other president became jealous. In fact, they were very angry. And they started looking for some fault in Daniel to make him look bad to the king. They watched him, and they followed him. But they only found that he was faithful, honest, and downright incorruptible.
Daniel was incorruptible and he does his job very well. But he
and the king is very pleased with him, very pleased with him, very pleased.
And what's worse, he's faithful to King Darius. But he's faithful to his God and prays to him 3 times a day. I've got it. We'll trick Darius into signing a petition that'll make Daniel choose God or Darius. That's it. Come on.
You see how the plot thickened? And I hadn't even entered the picture yet. Oh, had I known what was coming, I'm sure I would have bitten off my claws.
King Darius, live forever.
Your Majesty, we presidents and governors of your land have decided that you should make a law that for the next 30 days, anyone who makes a petition to any daughter man besides you will be cast into the lion's den.
Anyone who asks a favor of God or man, except me, cast into the lion's den. Yes, yes, I like that. After all, I am the king. Page, bring me a scroll.
Now, Your Majesty, there's just one more little thing. We request your signature on this law so that it cannot be canceled or changed.
Yes, yes, cannot be canceled or changed. Canceled or changed. Canceled or changed.
Bring me my pen. Now it is law. Spread the word around the kingdom.
always looking for faults in other people. Oh, well, that just really tangles my tail. Oh, but when they found Daniel praying to his God, oh, they just ran to the throne room with the news.
King Darius, live forever.
Your Majesty, haven't you signed the decree that says that permits no petitions to any god or man for 30 days?
Yes, yes, and it cannot be canceled or changed, canceled or changed.
And I seem to recall that you said anyone who disobeyed you would be cast into the lion's den.
The lion's den.
Yes, it is the law, and it cannot be canceled or changed.
Oh, King, Daniel is that man.
Decisions, do important things, write laws. Use a signet ring to have powers over men and things. But now you see that when that power is misused, a man as good as Daniel can be abused.
Thank you.
couldn't sleep. All he could do was pain, pain, pain. Little did he know that his number one lion couldn't open his mouth because something called an angel had closed it. I couldn't eat. I couldn't sleep. All I could do was pain, pain, pain. Oh, look, dawn is coming. And soon the king's going to be down to see what has happened. I better get back to my place and pack. Oh, woe is me. Woe is me. What's a lion to do?
Paige, let us go see if Daniel's God was able to deliver him.
Glory, glory.
Stop talking like that. Thank you all for coming tonight. Didn't these kids do a wonderful job?